as on the previous 3 days, the day four proceedings began with a short video highlighting the previous day's activities. Following the video, two participants, Ms. ULS Kumudni and Mr. AP Malika Arachi, briefly explained the activities of the previous day. In the first technical presentation of the day, Dr. B.R. Subramanian, consultant with the National Center for Sustainable Coastal Management, Chennai, made a presentation on the causes, types, and effects of pollution. He mentioned that pollution in the sea originates either from land-based sources or from sea-based sources. However, 80% of the pollution comes from land-based sources, originating from discharge of untreated sewage and industrial effluents, said Dr. Subramanian. He said that release of untreated sewage depletes dissolved oxygen in the sea, causing death of animals. Heavy metals and insecticides are present in untreated waste, and when their concentration is high, they cause several ailments to human beings, such as gastrological and neurological disorders.
Coming to plastics, the plastic is the biggest nuisance in the environment, but it is one of the best inventions of the human beings. There is no place where the plastic is not used. Everywhere plastic is used, and then it's very, very difficult to eliminate practice from human use.
Dr. Subramanian said that plastics contribute to bulk of solid waste disposed in the environment and are harmful to fishes and other marine organisms. Plastics in the sea break down as microplastics and find way into the animal body, affecting their digestive and respiratory systems and finally causing death. Talking about oil pollution, Dr. Subramanian said that the oil spilled from ships and offshore platforms contribute to about 20% of the marine pollution. Oil spills occur due to grounding and accident of ships and blowout from offshore oil fields. Rupture of submarine oil pipelines too cause oil spills. Dr. V. Sampath, marine fisheries expert, in his presentation on invasive species, defined invasive species as mentioned in the Convention on Biodiversity and the International Union for Conservation of Nature. He highlighted the sources and pathways of introduction of alien species into the terrestrial and aquatic ecosystems with examples, and said that such introductions could be intentional or unintentional. Discharge of ballast water by ships is one of the major sources of invasive alien species.
And then, you know, any organism, including bacteria, fungi, or plants, or insects, fish, amphibians, reptiles, birds, mammals, all of them, or their spores, or young ones, or seeds, or the eggs, or the offsprings, you know, which have been introduced into the new system, which is not native to them, I think they have an adverse impact on the ecosystem as well.
Dr. Sampath further explained the mechanism of ecosystem services, alteration by the invasive species, and their effects on environment, economy, society, and human well-being. Citing examples of some invasive species in South Asia, he referred to the weed Parthenium, Acacia, Prosopis, Water Hyacinth, Kappa Ficus, Red Algae, Tilapia, Chinese Carps, African Magur, and shrimp diseases in aquaculture systems. Dr. Sampath further explained the international conventions and treaties related to controlling the spread of invasive alien species for minimizing their adverse impacts and the measures for prevention and management of invasive species. In the third presentation on control and prevention of pollution and conventions on pollution, Dr. Subramanian said that pollution in the sea can be prevented and controlled by prescribing discharge standards derived based on pollution assessment techniques. Plastics can be eliminated by adopting the 4R policy, namely refuse, reduce, reuse and recycle. He said that legislation could play a key role in prevention and control of pollution. In conclusion, Dr. Subramanian cited few international conventions relating to control of sea-based pollution. He also stressed the need to carry out environment impact assessment for pollution assessment and strict enforcement of legislations.
We are coming to a conclusion, the development of safe limits. The safe limits are very, very important. Many countries ignore and then now they repent and try to do something which we cannot say. Once pollutant goes into the sea, we cannot recover. Not possible.
Following the three presentations, the participants wrote down the types and sources of pollution in the coastal and marine waters of Sri Lanka. Each participant carried out this exercise separately. Of the many pollutants listed by the participants, oil spills emerged as the most serious, followed by plastics and agricultural runoff. They also identified the impacts and seriousness of each pollutant. Post lunch, the participants broke into three groups.
1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3.
Ah, good, 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 good.
And carried out causal analysis on oil spills, plastics and agriculture runoff, including pesticides. Each group then made a presentation on the assigned topic, explaining the proximate and root causes.
Proxies, no control over plastic usage, roof of lack of attitudes, easy usage, low cost, extremely difficult to avoid use of plastic, management measures is taxing on plastic.
Our topic is oil spills. In that case, we have identified seven proxy causes. Those are aircraft crashes, accidents in large ships, unavailability of proper pumping mechanism from tankers, overcapacity of marine fishing fleet, unavailability of proper infrastructure facilities for oil exploration, lack of regulation to protect marine environment, and releasing of unburned oil from fishing fleet.
We identified more use of fertilizer. They are also damage to ecosystem and increase the disease, harmful for aquatic plant and fish. Our management measures develop usage of compost. We call organic agriculture improve the country.
The participants also suggested possible management actions to remedy the issues. With this, the day's activities came to conclusion and the participants returned to their hotel.